Well, you can already see what a fabulous place Chengdu is, and welcome to the Shuangliu Sports Center Stadium, where it's the start of the athletics program today. 6 days of competition from the best students in the world here to compete for gold. We start off tonight with some fantastic events in China. They will be looking for gold already. It's the women's 10,000 meters final tonight, and China have three runners in that. And there is a chance as well for Chinese gold in the shot put.
Here we go. Eighth ranked in the world, Song Yuan. She will be expecting gold. She set up to spin, tucks that ball tightly into the net. And there you go. That's over 18 meters. There would have been some anxious moments before she came into the circle here. She stood up nicely on the delivery, but just lost that smoothness that you need to get good distances. But she'll comfortably go into the lead with 18 meters 24. And the rest of this group have to now chase that distance. Mazenauer of Switzerland coming into the circle for her second round attempt. So Mazenauer, 16.78. Currently, that puts her in second position behind the Chinese Song. And you can see that she's reasonably happy with that performance. So Mazenauer from Switzerland. Switzerland generally across the events, field and track, churning out some very good performers now across the world. Readout for her fourth round attempt. So the left-hander, the only left-hander in this group of 12 in the shot put final. Well, she seemed to get behind that effort. So Riedel starting to warm up nicely in this event. She's got a best of 17.86 set in 2021. And the medal position behind Song, who clearly leads with that throw over 18 meters in the first round. And she goes 16.78. So she's moving up this leaderboard. So 16.73. For the Portuguese, and that's out towards that 18 meter line for the Portuguese athlete Aruda Bandeira. So Aruda Bandeira stays in but goes out towards that edit, and it's over 17 meters and she moves up to second position. The left-handed Germany Riedel. And that's way, way past 16 meters. And the Germans and the Swiss and everybody associated with this young lady, very pleased, very tidy across the circle. Nice speed, good rotation, good block at the front with that left foot. Sorry, with the right foot for the left hander. She goes 17.32. So that's just below her season's best of 17.41. And that puts her up into the silver medal position.
Nice crowd here tonight, John, as they're watching a very entertaining shot put.
And they're expecting success too, Angus. So into the circle is Song, who leads, has led since the first round, where she put 18 meters 24. Eighth ranked in the world this year, very fast in that spinning technique. And that's over 18 meters again. And that could well be her best attempt so far in this fifth round. Song, who is the last to throw when they change the order after the first three rounds. Eighth to first, so eighth ranked goes through as the first putter in the fourth round. And Song, who came first in those first three rounds, goes further ahead, 18.56. We have the Portuguese athlete Aruda Bandeira looking very athletic in the circle and way, way out towards that 18-meter line. Now, she currently, after the fifth round, sits in bronze medal position behind the German Riedel. And she thinks she's nailed that to push her up the board. She's not going to catch Song, who leads comfortably with that two puts over 18 meters. 17:47. And Song not taking her sixth round put. She threw 18:56 on her fifth round. She had 18:24 on her first round. She topped and tailed this shot competition. Eighth ranked in the world this year, fifth in the Olympics previously. And the Portuguese, Elana Arruda Bandeira, takes the silver medal with her final effort in this fantastic women's shot put competition. It was a comfortable win for Song.
Gets the 10,000 meters. And there is the field. Now, having seen a Chinese victory in the shot put earlier, Ma Zhuzhen will be hoping to deliver a first track gold medal, and if she does it, it means that China will have won their second title in the 10,000 meters, the first of which came only 4 years ago in Italy. So then the tension rises, crowd know what's going on. 25 laps of this track and we are underway. Two starts, good to see that many women in the race, that it requires that. And they go off at a pretty pedestrian pace early on. It has cooled down a lot. It's the right time to have this race towards the end of the evening. I've even started to feel a little bit of a chill, but I think that's just relative to what we had earlier, as my colleague John Trower is still sweltering alongside me. Wow, they're almost walking down that back straight. Well, they've obviously decided it's hot too, and then finally somebody decides that that's quite enough of that. Let's actually start running. I think it's the Norwegian, Marte Lien Jonsson, who has taken up the running. The woman who goes to the University of Oulu, 23 years old. Won in Nice at a 5,000 metres earlier on in the summer, right at the end of May. It's not exactly what I would call a pace, but she has at least picked it up a little bit. The Chinese, though, are all behind her. There they are, in the yellow and red. However, they are being tracked by the Japanese, Tomo Muramatsu. Ma Zhuzhen, born in the year that the Olympic Games took place in Sydney. She was only born, actually, a couple of weeks before they started, the woman who goes to the Chengdu Sport University. Well, I did get my pace notes out for this, John, but to be honest with you, I don't think that my pace notes will actually cover this.
Well, you know, I've got a bit of a gap between events. I was thinking about putting my shorts on and joining in. I think they're probably going at my pace.
Yeah, it's a very tactical race. At least the Norwegian Jonsson is beginning now to just wind it up just a little bit, which is good. This title was won by Zhang Dushun of China in 2019. Inside the Sao Paulo stadium, which is where Napoli play, who won the Serie A title in the men's football earlier this year. A return to form for them. This is a stadium where it's actually open, apparently, to the local people of Chengdu. They can come in here and do their own exercise, which is great. It hosts football matches as well. And tonight it's hosting the women's 10,000 metres. The crowd have not really been drawn into this event just yet because they're keeping their powder dry at the moment, to say the least. So we have just about got to halfway. When they get to the next 200 metre point, they will have reached halfway. And you can see that they are, well, the reason why I haven't been talking about the pace is because really, it's not really the important thing tonight, because they are pretty much on, I would say, 35 minute pace at the moment, which is it's quite slow, but the championships can sometimes go this way.
Well, the thing is, we could have a surprise here, because if it comes down to the last 600 meters and there's still half a dozen in contention, somebody could actually, who's got a bit of speed endurance in their legs, left in their legs could just take off and the others might not catch.
Yeah, this kind of pace, it does lend itself to those who've got a slightly slower personal best, season's best. It will fill them with confidence that perhaps they might be able to create some sort of a surprise. Japanese have disappeared back into the pack. And you can see that the lead has been taken over by the Turkish woman, Karasu, 27-year-old. She's the oldest woman in the race from the Agri Ibrahim Sesen University. Runs half marathons as well. This is her first major championships, and she is the first to go. That's the biggest gap we've seen, and she's been joined at the front as well. It's a 5 maybe meter gap. The others have decided that they're not ready to go yet. We are only just past halfway, so this is a little bit of a gamble perhaps by the two in front, but they are definitely making a concerted charge here, and the gap is steadily growing. And now behind, they're beginning to realize that they don't want them to get quite that far ahead. So then in front at the moment, it's the two Turks, Kilic Gönen, the 26-year-old. They both go to the Agri Ibrahim Sesen University. The leader has a 32:43 personal best, which he set this year. Behind her is slightly slower, 20 seconds slower, but new personal best figures this season for Karasu. And they've decided that they will give it a go, but you can see there that a little break, it's a little bit like cycling, isn't it? Somebody breaks off the back, the front of the peloton, and then the others decide whether it's worth going with them. And in the end, you can see that the woman who's been sent out to get them is Jia Yu, and she has been consistently working for Mars since the beginning of the race.
Yeah, the girl in front looks quite comfortable, but she's going to let somebody else go through here. And it now will be who has got the mindset and the courage to stay and wait, or the alternative is to go away from the field.
Well, Mar is still taking it easy. She's still 8 meters behind. The two Turks working together. It's not really the one as Gia I was expected to really be in front. She's a woman, though, who's run 32:47. Most experienced in the field, as we said, and on a night like this, that does count for something. Bronze medalist in the 10,000 meters at the Asian Championships back in 2019. And in the last World University Games, albeit 4 years ago, she was 10th in this race and before doing the half marathon, which she didn't finish. But she's looking good at the moment. Very good indeed, just tracking those two Turkish front runners. And Ma looks like she's struggling. She's disappearing further and further behind.
Yeah, I think when you have a race like this and three make a break, the fourth position, it's heartbreakingly hard to get in back into the race. And of course, in recent games, you know, you've got the big screen available to see in the stadium, so you can see that they know categorically that they're in a breakaway group of three. The three medals, as long as they can finish the race, will end up in their pockets, and they can see how close they are or how far they are behind, and they can see the faces of the athletes in front of them just to see if they're struggling a little bit or not.
It was Dara Maslova of Kyrgyzstan who won the title when this Games was hosted by Chinese Taipei back in 2017, beating the Indian Sanjivani Yadav. That was a lovely moment to see two lesser known distance running nations come through and grab some glory. It was a very hot and sticky night that night too, actually, in the Taipei City. Still chugging out the laps. Six laps to go now. Just under 2,500 meters to go. We are getting to the stage now where they will start to think about what's going on. I think that the Chinese are going to be very happy just to stay there until the end and just maybe use a kick to go past them. But who has got it? That's the case. They're all looking up at the big screen. There are big screens at both ends of the track. This is where you start to wonder. You want to know what's going on inside the head of your competitors. How are they feeling? You're looking for anything that will tell you on the face. And of course, those who are running next to you are trying to show nothing of what they were doing. The Ethiopians were always masters of that, not showing you how much pain they were in. There's Mar. She's in pain because she's a long way back. We expected her to be fighting it out for a medal, but it is not going to be her night. And just coming up to one of the Indians. A little bit of a stretch here being put in by Kilic Gurnan. As she goes past the Indian woman, Basanti Kumari. Five laps to go. 2,000 metres. We have the men's 3,000 metre steeplechase coming up. Last on the track after this. This is the business end now. We are getting towards the point where we will sort out the medal. And it's great that we have three women all together. It would have been nice to have a fourth, but three will do. Again, Gia decides to go out and get a drink. And it's interesting that the two Turks have resisted that. Hydration being taken by the Chinese, and the Turks again resist the urge to go and get a drink. So then, smart tactics, or is she wasting energy by going and just running those extra couple of meters? We will find out now. Around about 1,500 meters to go. It's come down to this. Nobody has yet making a burst. Nobody really interested. But my money at this stage, I think, is on the Chinese girl. She looks the most comfortable. She's got the most spring in her legs. But I know that you can't always judge that. Some people just have a slightly heavier style of running. They are still looking to see whether or not they've broken her. And this would suggest to me that they know that the Chinese girl has a better kick over that last part of the race. Four laps to go, about a mile. They switch again. But Shia is looking very, very good indeed. Lots of experience. Asian Championships, World Youth Olympics, National Games, Asian Championships. 10th in 2019 in this race in Naples. Also has cross-country in her legs as well, going back to 2019 at the World Championships. Didn't really figure very highly in that, nevertheless. And you can see the Turks, they are trying to just move it up a bit. Well, in long distance racing, when you break, it happens quickly. At the moment, nobody is breaking. And the Chinese crowd are getting behind their woman. Looking to become only the third champion. The two Turks in front of her, looking to emulate Fadime Suna, who won this title in 2011, the last time that these games were in China, in Shenzhen, just north of Hong Kong, all the way down in the south of the country. 30 seconds reached, three laps to go. Again, they switch over. It's systematic, metronomic. As soon as they go across the finish line, they switch over. It's 400 metres in front each. However, they really look like they've slowed down, and the Chinese is almost up the backsides. She almost ran into the back of the one of the Turkish women there. They are looking around. This time, she's actually looking across to see where Mar is, and Mar is on the other side of the track. She was supposed to be running for her tonight, I think, but it's going to be Shia who will either grab glory or it will be bronze. I think from this stage, she will not think bronze is enough.
I think if you just look at what's going on here with the two Turks, they're almost trying to provide a barrier with their bodies. They're changing over here, and they'll change again perhaps in another 200 metres. But
here she
at
goes.
Some point...
Gia going round the outside into second place, and maybe that Turkish resistance is beginning to break. Gia into second. All she has now between her and the lead is Yala Kilic Gurnan. They are looking a bit more tired, especially Karusu. You notice there, that's the first time, and a little look round there by a teammate. Where are you? We're supposed to swap over when we go past the finish line, but it's all over. It's now Turkey against China for the gold medal. Turkish resistance breaking. Gia, this is a brilliant race from her. Tracking only the last Turk. With only 800 metres to go, now only 700 metres to go. The crowd rising down the back straight. They sense a victory. After victory in the shot put earlier in the evening, China won the first two gold medals of the athletics track and field programme. 6 days of competition, Caruso, you can see that the pain on her face. I said when you go quickly, and she's the first to crack.
And the leading Turk here looks as though she's tough. So she may not look like a speed merchant in terms of what's in her legs, but I tell you what, she's tough. And she's staying there. I know the Chinese athlete is waiting and waiting, but can the Turkish girl hang on and make it difficult for her?
Turkey have only taken one medal in this event since its inception, all the way back in 1985. Will they manage to add another gold? It'll either be a second gold medal for Turkey in this event, or it'll be a third for China. And she looks like she's gearing up now, Shia, as they head towards the bell. Through, and Shia decides, head down, knees up, in front. And here comes Shia, breaking away. 4 meters, 5 meters, 6 meters, off she goes. This race is over. The Turks ran valiantly, but it's going to be Chinese gold. Shia, the most experienced woman in the race. Beautifully timed tactics. Didn't need to run in a slow race. And she has burst away. And look what she has done to the opposition in 200 metres. The bell goes for Ma, who is 200 metres behind her teammate, who is now going around the back bend. The crowd rising, a tremendous atmosphere here inside the Shanglao Sports Centre Stadium, and she comes off the bend. Wonderful running from Xia Yuyu of China, the 25-year-old who goes to the Tsinghua University, comes away to become the third Chinese woman to win the 10,000 metres at the World University Games. Punches the air, and it's gold for China, and it's gold as well for the Tsinghua University. Wonderful running. Turkey will take silver and bronze. Brave running there from, first of all, Kılıçgören, who gets the silver, and then Fatma Kudasu, who will take the bronze. But it's a double gold for China tonight on the first day of athletics. What a fantastic race, what a fantastic run, and the biggest win of her career. So then, confirmation there of that wonderful gold medal for Xia Yuyu in 33 minutes 48.35 out of Yala Kılıçgören of Turkey and Fatma Kürasu Konan of Turkey.